على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة والموفون بعهد إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, I remember my last Friday sermon. I was talking about one verse in the Quran. That is first ayah, is ayah number 177 in Surah Al-Baqarah. And that ayah, I have chosen it because it gives you almost the fundamentals of Islam. So it teaches us the pillars and fundamentals of Islam. And what I feel is that in this century, our Muslims, we are very close to fall into the trap that the previous nation is falling into, which is what we in Quran calls يُحَرِّفُونَ الْكَلِمَ عَنْ مَوَاضِعِهِ. They change and transform the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from its position. So they relocate the words of Allah. That's the Quran. And how do they do that? Not necessarily that they take the ayah and put it in another location, but it is that the meaning goes into different way. They devalue the words and they leave the essence of that commandment. Then it becomes a different. To highlight it in an example, let me give you one example. My topic today is about the essence of sadaqah. So nowadays, the type of sadaqah usually we have is that you maybe slaughter a goat, have a nice food, dinner or lunch in your house, and invite your friends and people who are high level, especially those who are higher than you. So you invite only the dignitary people and your friends to your house, and you say, I have given sadaqah. So if we continue that now in these years, what will happen? In next generation will argue to say, this is sadaqah. Sadaqah is that you make an invitation to your people like friends and so, then that is the meaning of sadaqah. And nobody will believe sadaqah has another meaning. Even though the word is there in the Quran, still the practice is different. And that's my point for this ayah, which I have said it will take long. But today, inshallah, I want to touch one word of this ayah. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين. So that is one section. First Allah says the righteousness, qualitativeness and good, being pious and being benign, it doesn't mean that you turn your face towards east or towards east, west or east. It is not about actions and rituals and practices. It is something which is based on belief. And then Allah says, وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ. But righteousness is the one who believes in Allah. One who believes in Allah, number one. وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ, and the last day, يَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ, and the angels. والكتاب, and the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the angels, all the books. والنبيين, and all the prophets. So that is one section. The other section is starting from وَآتَ الْمَالَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ ذَوِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَابْنَ السَّبِيلِ وَالسَّائِلِينَ وَفِي الرِّقَابِ. That's another section. Today I have chosen this section, which is starting from وَآتَ الْمَالَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ. Allah is saying وَآتَ الْمَالَ, that's one part. The second part then, وَآتَ الْمَالَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ. Those who spend their wealth in spite of love for it, in spite of love for that property, that material, that money, and still they give charity. They spend it to other people, and then they give it, they spend it on the relatives, orphans, helpless people, needy people, those who are on journey, the travelers, and those beggars, those who ask for it, and on redemption of captive, to ransom someone who has been hijacked by people or arrested or someone you set free as slave. That is how it is. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now is telling us that He did not just left us saying وَآتَ الْمَالَ, that's it. Or just وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةُ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. If the Quran would have limited to say you pay charity, today maybe the way we have transformed the meaning of the words would have a base of argument. But now Allah has given us a detailed explanation on how to pay, who is the beneficiary, and who is paying. All those things are in clear cut. And to be in advance, I would like to know, I would like just to clarify to distinguish two things. Having ceremony, like birthday, like the achievement you did, and you invite your friends and your family members and whoever you want, and you have a dinner that time, that is one category. You may get rewarded because based on your heart, what your intention is. If your intention is that, maybe when you invite those people, later on they will help you, or they will pay back to you. Then your intention is there. You may get it or you may not get it. Then if your intention is about getting rewarded because of the food, whoever you pay to, you will get that rewarded. But the sadaqah is different. Also there is a difference between sadaqah and zakat. I will come to it soon. But this sadaqah is for those people, those who are in these categories. And what you are paying is what you love. So what you love for yourself is what you are paying for charity, sadaqah. Not what is the discarded ones, not the leftovers, and not the ones that you don't want to even see. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says many verses in the Quran, Allah addresses that specifically. For example, there is an ayah in Surah Al-Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ بِعَلِيمٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بِعَلِيمٍ. Allah is saying, you can never attain righteousness, the birr, unless you obey or spend in the cause of Allah, that which you love, you dearly cherish. That things, when you pay what you really love for charity, then that's when you get the reward. But not what you don't want to do. And what you don't want is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also specifically classified it, and specifically is telling us in another verse, which is in Surah Al-Baqarah, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا يا أيها الذين آمنوا انفقوا من طيبات ما كسبتم ومما أخرجنا لكم ولا تيمموا الخبيث منه تنفقون ولستم بآخذيه إلا أن تغمضوا فيه واعلموا أن الله غني حميد الشيطان يعدكم الفقر، الشيطان يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء، والله يعدكم مغفرة منه ورحمة. In this verse, in English, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, all believers spend in Allah's way the portion of the wealth that you have lawfully earned. Spend in Allah's way the like a portion, the portion you really love of your property, of your money, which you have gained it legally. Not something that you have stolen, not something that came through even an unclear income. It should be an income which is halal in the first place. And then it should be money that you love. And it should be one that you really need, but still you prefer to be given to that person who is more needy than you. And then Allah is saying, and what we have produced for you from the earth. And Allah is specifically again saying, وَلَا تَيَمَّمُ الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ. And do not pick out for charity those of worthless things that you yourself would not accept. Accept that with closed eyes. إِلَّا وَلَا تَيَمَّمُ الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِهِ إِلَّا أَنْ تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ. The things that you yourself would not accept it, or you will not take it, unless you are taking it while you are closing your eyes, don't give that. And bear in mind that Allah is saying, bear in mind that Allah is self-sufficient and Allah is praiseworthy. And then Allah is saying, Shaytan threatens you with poverty, which doesn't even exist, but he shows you and prompts you to commit that is indecent actions. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises you for forgiveness, his forgiveness and his bounty. That is, so then you see the highways are very clear. One highway which is leading you to that torment in this life and hereafter. While in this life you are worried about becoming poor, losing property, so and so. So you are in trouble, even in this world, you are already in the adab. And hereafter you will get the more adab. And that is when you follow the satanic ways. Or you have been influenced by the shaitan. But when you follow the wa'ad, the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will be self-sufficient in this world. And hereafter, you will get paradise. That is the meaning of giving sadaqah. I want to go into giving an example so that to be more clear that what we know, we have to learn lessons from the history, from the cultures, from everything. So let me be precise to cultures. If you go to Western Africa, those tribal societies in Western Africa, you will find people having an occasion. One is a month or once a year. So they make the most expensive food, they prepare the most expensive food, very important food, a lot of food, and they carry the food on their head, go to the river banks, and when they go there, they splitter the food into the river. They take all that food in the river, they put it in the river or near the river. And that is, they say it is sadaqah. That's what they think is sadaqah. That from there you can know that there was a religion before that have reached to that people, and all they remember now is paying charity. But they don't know how to pay charity. And that's where we are going to now. If we keep making charity in big houses, having luxurious things, and we have left in this position, we are ending up to that position. If you come to the Eastern Africa, especially in between Kenya and Ethiopia, those tribal people, once in their occasions, they want to give charity. But what they do, they take the food, they prepare nice food, slaughter goats, and take milk especially, and that milk they spill into the earth, pouring milk into the earth, like they are watering a tree. That's what they do. So what they think, they know, they remember there was something called sadaqah that existed before. Then their religion became so limited, so shrinking to that level. And come to another point, I don't want to be to offend anybody, but this is like a culture which is going on. And it's not their fault now, but it's only to get awake, to be awakened and to understand the meaning of what you are doing. Even come to Southeast Asia, you see people who have those statues of Buddha or anyone else, taking food every morning for them, orange, apple, any kinds of food, putting in front of you, leaving it there. And so the food is there, waiting for somebody who's going to eat. So they say we are feeding God, because they think, they have heard that in fiqh fi sabilillah, they in the cause of Allah. So they think that God himself needs food to eat. And they have taken to that level. That means they have some remnants of the religion that was ordering the sadaqah. And now, if we continue this situation, we will end up to that level or worse. So that is the whole point. And when you are giving charity, you must be giving it out of consciousness, sincerity. The meaning of sadaqah came from the root word of sidq, the truthfulness. That it's from deep heart belief and truthfully you are giving it. And when you are giving that sadaqah, it doesn't mean that you get something from that person in exchange. But you have to be specific to the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in which Allah is saying, وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا إِنَّا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا. You must be like those, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He is giving us the description of the righteous people, He is saying that they are, among them are those who feed the poor people, the orphans, and the captive. Allah is again repeating always, those are specific people who are the beneficiaries of the sadaqah. And they are giving that sadaqah to that people for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for the love of the people even. So then, and they will say to them, and we feed you for the sake of Allah alone. And we do not ask you from, we are not expecting from you any rewards or any thanks from you. No, we seek neither thanks not reward from you, but we are just giving to you. Why? Because we fear our Lord's torment in the disturbance, the day of disturbing day. That day, which is very torment, in the torment punishment comes. That's what they are afraid of. And that's how they pay their charity. And when you are paying the charity, that means it's coming from your deep heart. You pay it and you expect it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you more than what you have paid. At least you will get self-content. At least you will not be worried about poverty. Even if you don't have that material still, you don't feel that it is missing from you. And then when you are giving to that person or group, you know they are, it is them who are receiving it. But Allah is the one who is taking it from you and giving it to that people. خُدْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُضَهِرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Take sadaqah from them, which is purifying them and glorifying them. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. My dear respectful brothers and sisters, my point is that, as I have started with when I was explaining this verse, I have said that we want to come back to know and to understand the meaning, the values, the essence of our Quran, so that we practice it correctly. Then the same applies to the authentic Sunnah. Then well, that is the whole point. And this segment of the ayah in Baqarah 177, in this segment is all about how to pay charity and who is the receiving person and who is the one who is paying. So the person who is paying that charity should not feel when he pays that, oh my God, now I don't have money, I'm already broke, I paid all my money. And he feels that kind, which is called shuh, selfishness and greediness. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in another verse in Surah Al-Hashr about this. Allah is saying, وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَّةٌ وَمَنْ يُوقَ شُحَّ نَفْسِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. Among those, the righteous people, among them are those who refuge to them, those who come to them for help. They love them. They love to get guests. They love to welcome a needy person, a poor person, to their house. And when they receive that people, then and they give something to them, they will not entertain any jealousy or selfishness in their hearts because of what they have paid. And what then? What else? وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةٌ. So they even prefer to the needy person over themselves. When they have this much of food, they will say, instead of me eating it, let this person who is starving, let him eat now. And then they will say to the person, no, don't worry, I've eaten it. Then those ones, they are the ones who, even Allah is saying, وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصَةٌ, even though they themselves are poor people. They are very poor, but at the same time, they love to pay charity, sadaqah. Because why? Because they know that this person has a right on their property. The poor person has full right to get a portion of your property. And even if you deny that right, what would happen? It turns to violence and chaos. And that's why in our modern world, we pay taxes. And if we don't pay the tax, what happens is that people who are the poor people will come and attack the wealthy people, and they will take their property. Then there will be, the whole area will be chaos and wars all the time. So in order to make sure there's peace and security, there must be wealth distribution. You must share whatever you have with your brothers and sisters. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in the Quran, وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. And those people, in their property, there's a right for the people who are the beggars and the disabled people, those who are impaired from working and have some kind of disability. They have a right there. So this, you share your wealth with the needy people and the weak people. That is how then you can get that, you yourself, you can be safe and you can be in good situation all the time. So this doesn't mean only that you are only getting rewards from Akhirah, you are waiting, but even in this world, you are getting that benefit. So how do you reach that? It's just to combat the ego. Your ego, which is telling you that you will be poor, the shaitan's influence, which is saying to you, you will get, you will become so poor. Don't do it. Don't pay this one. That's what the challenge. And that one is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's something which is created in us. Allah is saying, وَوَحْدِرَتِ الْأَنْفُسُ الشُّحَّ. The soul is always have this thing of shukr, the bukhl, which is fear of poverty. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in hadith, the best bayan of sadaqah is that anta saddaqa wa anta sahihun shahihun wa ta'mal al-isha wa takhsha al-faqr. That you pay something while you are afraid of poverty, but still you are paying it. Even though you are in that dilemma, you pay it. And at the same time, you know that you are worried about your daily food, but you expect good. That is the best way of giving sadaqah. In that case, the love of the money, the material, and properties and prosperity that you have should be always superseded by the love of rewarding. So the love of rewarding should supersede all those of material loves. And in that case, then you go to that level of that you are being the real sadaqah, which is not a fantasy, which is not that you are show off, you are just making show off. Some people, they invite people to their houses, just that person maybe to see the decoration of their houses and so on and so on. That means you're only making show off, which is opposite to sadaqah. And then the meaning of the sadaqah is all about giving it in this way to the needy person, to the person who deserves, not to the wrong way. Otherwise, we will end up to the examples that I have mentioned, and I apologize if I'm offending anybody, but I'm talking about the cultures that exist today, including our Western culture, which is now mixing up with inviting people and offering dinner to your friends and sadaqah. So then those things, the things must be in clear cut. You have to distinguish between sadaqah and zakat, and between inviting friends and giving sadaqah, and between contributing to rebuilding the society or community contribution and giving sadaqah. And when you are contributing to the development of your community, it is sadaqah, but that sadaqah is in another category, which is development. For example, we have in this masjid here, and now we are worried about paying the rent, where we were supposed to buy the whole building. Now our problem is how to pay the rent. That is even, it is not even coming from the sadaqah side, but also from the dignity. Like, somebody would think, what kind of community are they if they cannot buy the whole building? Or leave alone to buy the whole building because of many reasons, but to pay the rent, monthly rent, which is so easy. My dear brothers and sisters, today my topic was just like that, وَآتَ الْمَالَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ. And then next was وَآتَ الزَّكَاةِ. So we can talk about zakat, what the zakat and the differences of two different zakats, and then after that the conclusion will be the last part of the ayah, وَالْمُفُونُ بِعَهْدِهِ. But now, I appeal to you that inshallah today you will be, you generously pay whatever you can so that you can pay the rent. Inshallah, we are not making now to take the box and go around, but somebody will sit at the door, and inshallah, I hope everybody will just contribute something. That is one inshallah I am advising to yourself and myself. And the other thing that I would like to make brothers and sisters, paying sadaqah, it's not only money. You can pay your effort, your manpower, and you can pay your idea, you can pay your knowledge, and also the easiest you can do is dua. So to make dua for the people who are in need of dua, that's to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua, I would say, inshallah, here are two sisters who are almost twins, I guess, Alesha and Felicia, they need your dua. So inshallah, I hope you will just give your dua as a sadaqah. And also, his brother Jihan Hamid, who is also expecting a baby, inshallah, I hope that we will not be stingy even to give dua. So the giving out something has these levels, inshallah. So I will just conclude with that, and I would say, like, one statement to the Somali speaking people. Walaal intana Somali qaadasha waxa way masjidka wa masjidkeena wa ina ogaataan sadaqadina iyo waxba waa halkaan la timaadaan waxa jooga imaam Soomaali imaamku waa Soomaali aniga khudbayna waa Soomaali marka insha Allah sidaas idinkana ula socda wasalaamu calaykum wa aqimus salaam.